objects and classes. Let's start simple. Here we've got a collection of objects. Their name is written on the left. How would you group these objects? You could put them in things we eat, for example, living things, or even by the size and shape. So there's different ways we can categorize these objects. So if you want to put them in groups, we could, for example, put them in edible, so food and drink, animals, transport, plants, toys, school items, and the hands probably by itself. So we've got these groups, how could we name them? Well, the apple, cake and sandwich are foods, cat, bird and dog, animals, flower and tree or plants, truck, bicycle, vehicles. Quite straightforward. So these groups could be called classes. So we could put these objects into classes. So we've got the food class, the animal class, the plant class, and the vehicle class. In this video, we're going to have four parts. Part one, we're going to define a class. Then we're going to write functions, which are called methods in class. We're going to continue that in part three. And in part four, we're going to show you the best way of what we're doing in this video. So let's look at part one, define a class. How do we do this in Python? Start off with the word class, then we have the class name. It's convention to use an uppercase letter to start a class name. So in Python, like other program languages, we normally use this uppercase capital letter when we're dealing with a class. Then the colon, then some code underneath. So we had the class for food, the animal class, the plant class, and the vehicle class. So we grouped these objects into these classes. So we can put other objects into these classes as well. Things that we eat, we can put in food, living things, in animals, other plants, and other vehicles into those classes. And we can identify objects by these categories. We can identify objects by some characteristics about them. So here's an example. We've got something that's a living thing. It hasn't got leaves and it's got four legs. So what do you think that is? Well, if you look at the objects, that's probably either the cat or the dog. So the answer was a dog or a cat. So we would normally say an animal with four legs. So that object is in the animal class, and a characteristic of an animal is that it has a number of legs. So let's go back to the code. So we had class animal, the animal class, and now we can add a variable, number of legs equals four. Pretty straightforward. Okay, how did you find that? Was that easy? If you did find it easy, that's a good thing. Have a break, but come back, as it might get a little bit more complicated, but let's hope it's still simple. Okay, part two, class methods. Methods are just functions, but inside the class. So we've done functions before. It's not too different, so let's have a look. With a function, we call the function. So here's an example of a function called double number. We pass it y, and it comes back, it returns a value that goes into x. With a class, we create an object. So in the animal class, we could create the object dog. So we had the animal class. So class animal, number of legs equals four. Not all animals have four legs, as I'm sure you know. So can we tell Python the number of legs of the animal? Yes, we can. So we can use a function inside the class, and that's called a method. And one difference is it uses the word self to know what's inside itself, inside the class. So inside the class, the word self helps the class understand what's inside it. Let's have a look at an example. So we can define a function or it, as we call it in a class, a method called print hello. And what it's going to print is inside itself, so we're going to use the word self in brackets, then the colon, and then print hello. So that's pretty much the same, quite simple. We just use the word self inside the brackets. So here we have the function print hello, that prints hello. We have define def, the method name print hello. We have the brackets, what we're passing. We must include self. We have the colon, and then we have the code underneath with the indentation. So pretty much the same as what we used to with a normal function, but just with the word self added. So here, if we were defining a function called count legs, we could pass it legs, and we would have the number of legs equals legs. And the method is identical, except we add self in the brackets. And also, the number of legs, we put self dot number of legs rather than just number of legs. So we can see the use of the word self is the difference. With a function, we probably return the value number of legs. That's optional in a method. So we can create the class method. So we have the animal class, so class animal. We've got a variable, number of legs. We're going to make it 0. And then we've got the method, count legs, where we've got the number of legs equals the legs variable, which is going to be passed to it. So we're going to tell the class how many legs the animal has. So we know how to create the object, dog. So dog equals animal. And then to count legs, we use just the dot. So we've got the dog, which is the object. And to call the method, we use dog dot and then the method name. So dog dot count legs. The 4 in brackets is the number of legs that we're passing to the method. And that makes the number of legs inside the class equal 4. The code itself is quite straightforward, but using all of these words makes it sound a bit complicated. So we could create different animals. So here we've got an animal that's a dog, a cat, a fish, and a bird. And we can count legs, dog 4 legs, cat 4 legs, fish no legs, bird 2 legs. Really straightforward. Okay, is that still easy? I would suggest you make sure you understand everything so far. So if you need to go back and go through it again, then please do so. If you're still happy that you understand everything, then fine, carry on. So let's see what we've got next. Part 3, more class methods. So we can also add a print method. Generally we like to print things to see what we're doing. So here we've got our animal class, we've got our variable, and we've got our method. So now we're going to add another method. Again, same syntax, define, method name, self in brackets, and then we're going to print the number of legs. It's inside the class. So we're going to use self.numberofLegs. So using that, we can create the object dog. We can count the legs by using the method. So we say dog.countLegs. And then we can print it by saying dog.printLegs. That outputs 4. Could do that with other animals. So we can do this with a fish. Count legs 0, print legs. And that output's 0. At the moment, we've got just a simple print legs where it just prints the number. We could improve that statement. We want to really say something has legs. So here we're going to add a name and then the number of legs and also some text. So the name has number of legs, legs. So we've included a name there. So we're going to add another method to add the name. So now the user can add and pass a name to the class. So the class counts legs, adds a name, and prints legs. So there we say our code we have so far. So now when we print the number of animal legs, We create the dog, count the legs, add a name, in this case Rover, and then we're going to print the legs. So now the output is Rover has four legs. We do this with a fish. This fish is called Freddy. Freddy has zero legs. That's quite straightforward so far. I hope you understand that. We haven't really made a mistake, but we haven't shown you the best way. So, what is the best way? Let's see. Part 4, the best way. So here we've got a code that we've seen so far. We've got our animal class, we've got a variable, we've got three methods. You may have seen this before. Underscore underscore init, or initial, shortened to init, underscore underscore. And what's that? That's called a constructor. Yes, even more complicated words for you. So what is this all about? Okay, so you should use this, so let's have a look what it is. What it does is, in this example, you can create variables for each animal. So rather than creating the variable for all animals, it creates the variable for each animal. And it does make a difference. So we can use an example such as when you use a list to show how this makes a difference. So let's have a look at init first. So we can define the method the same as before. The method name is this underscore init underscore underscore. Then we've got self as usual. And in this example, we're going to use name and legs. So when we create variables, instead of just being at the top underneath the class, if we put them inside this initial method, that's a better way to give values inside the class to the object. As well as passing these variables into this method, you can have default values. So for example, we could have name is a blank name, a legs equals zero. So if nothing was passed, then the name would be blank and the legs would be zero. So if something's passed, it's given that value, and if something is not passed, it's given the default values. Don't have to do that, better to show you so you understand. So here we've got our method underscore underscore init underscore underscore. Yeah, that's the name. And here we construct the variables name and number of legs. So when we print it, we can print the name has number of legs, legs, using the self. So here we've got dog equals animal, Rover, four. So that means the name is Rover, legs are four. Output, Rover has four legs when we call the print legs method. Cat equals animal Tom 4. Print legs, Tom has four legs. Fish, Freddy has zero legs. I've shown you this, but it might seem a bit complicated, so perhaps we can explain it with an example. So let's have a look at this bad example. So this is what we had before. So here we're just going to use a list rather than a number of legs. So their list is called friends. So we're going to print our friends, straightforward. So here we've got an animal called Rover, and we're going to add the friend Tom to that list. So when we print it, we've got a list with Tom inside. So that's fine. Now we've got an animal called Tom, and we're going to add Rover to Tom's friends. And now we print it, and now we've got a list of Tom and Rover. So the friends of Tom are Tom and Rover. And that's the same Tom. So that's not what we wanted. This is not okay. We did not want Tom as the friend of Tom. So what happened there? Well, the class animals got this list called friends. So, and this list is now a list for all animals, but we want a list of friends for each animal. So rather than having this list as a class variable, just a variable inside the class, what we need to do is we need to construct it. So the variable goes in the init method, and that will allow us to have a list for each animal. The list is created for the object rather than all of the objects. So here we see our friends list, which will have self in front of it, so self.friends in the constructor method, which in Python is __init__. That's the name of it. Strange name, yes, but that's what it is. And then we can print the friends. So now when we add Tom to friends, we add it for Rover, and Rover hasn't got previous animals friends in the list. This is how we want it. This is okay. When we add Rover to Tom's friends, prints Rover, that's fine. So this is better. So if you just want to check this Python documentation we've described here, you can see the URL underneath, and the code that it describes has class dog, kind equals canine, and then the init method, which you can see. And that's a variable shared by all instances, means every time you create that an object of that class, then that kind will apply to all of them. Whereas if you use the initialization, this method, then that will create the name to each object. So one to everything, the other to each individual one. So it says, don't create the list, just as a variable, initialize it by putting it in this specific method. Specific meaning it's called __init__ or init. Okay, well, objects can get quite confusing, and there are certainly more to objects than we've shown you, but that's enough for today. Let's hope you understood what we've done so far. Okay, thank you for watching, and as always, if you haven't subscribed, please do so and subscribe and watch all of our videos. Okay, thank you, bye bye for now.